So what is dental charting? We're going to focus on what and why. Charting is writing or recording our findings in the patient record. So what findings? We have clinical findings of the hard and soft tissues. The teeth are hard tissues, soft tissues are, example, gingiva. And radiographic findings. And we use standardized symbols. The symbols need to be standardized for any given clinic so that each person who reads the charting can understand it and interpret it. Just as different offices can have different symbols, different offices can also have different charting diagrams. And a charting diagram is called an odontogram. These are some of the symbols we used when we used a paper chart. Symbols may or may not look like what it is symbolizing in the mouth. With digital charting, we have numerous colors we can use and various symbols. So why do we chart? We document. We're documenting our findings. We're documenting what we tell the patient and what the patient tells us. And we document what we do, our treatment and planned treatments. The chart is thus a legal document. It may be summoned by an attorney, and the chart may be summoned for identification of a patient. Dental radiographs can be used for forensics to identify a patient. Well, where does the information come from that we document? We look, we probe, we look at radiographs and interpret radiographs, and we talk and listen to our patients. Our objectives for the rest of the afternoon is to learn why we chart, to learn some symbols and colors, learn the sequence of charting, and learn periodontal charting. Charting can be done by the operator or by their assistant. When we have an assistant, we call that four-handed. So this would be four-handed charting. The operator, of course, would be wearing gloves and working intraorally. The assistant would not be wearing gloves and record on paper or digitally. This increases the efficiency and helps to avoid potential infection control issues. If the operator is going back and forth, intraoral to recording, there's a potential breach of infection control. There are ways to avoid it, but with an assistant, it's much more efficient. Other digital input methods could involve voice recognition, or in the early days of digital charting, there were foot pedals used, especially in periocharting, to input the numbers. Here we see a Saluda odontogram. Saluda is the software that we use here in the clinic for patient records. Now, to orient you some more to the odontogram in Saluda, the circles represent the anatomic crown. The outer circle represents the entire crown. The orange circle represents the occlusal or the incisal. And in Saluda, the incisal is actually more of an oval shape, to indicate an incisal edge. That helps you figure out where you are on that odontogram. In addition, though, there are numbers, 1 to 32, to help you figure out which tooth is which. When I crop the picture, I crop out the third molars, so that's why the third molars are not seen here. Now, another thing that's missing would be buccal and lingual. You know, which side is buccal, which side of the tooth is lingual on this odontogram? The lingual's in the middle. And I say just pretend that the tongue is right here in the middle. And so on the lower, the lingual side is on the top side of the circle, and the buccal side is the lower side of the circle. However, on the maxillary teeth, it's the opposite. Buccal is on the top, lingual is on the lower side of the circle. So if the middle circle is the occlusal or the incisal, then each of the four pieces around that circle represent the mesial, distal, buccal, and lingual. But just like buccal and lingual flip-flop depending on whether it's maxillary or mandibular, the mesial and distal will flip-flop depending on whether you're in the right half of the mouth or the left half of the mouth. In Salud, we have a diagnosis tab and a treatment planning tab. The yellow and blue arrows show you where you would find those tabs. So we go through the mouth, each tooth, for diagnosing, and then we go through the mouth again for treatment planning. In diagnosing, we are recording what we find, what's present now. So on this odontogram, we see tooth number one is missing. Tooth number two has an existing crown, as does 3, 4, and 5. Existing crown. So there's a C and a blue box around that C to show that it's existing and it is considered to be sound. Or I like to say it's happy. It's a happy tooth with a happy crown. If it needs to be replaced, then it's not happy. On the lower, we see a blue with some red. These crowns, here's a C, but half of it's red and half of it's blue. That means that that crown is defective. And the good part about Salud is we click on the symbol and then we click on the odontogram tooth, and we get all the words and codes that we need in another part on that page. So we're clicking on the teeth and symbols and generating a lot of information. The symbol for a crown, a square with the letter C, encompasses the entire coronal portion of the odontogram tooth, because when we prepare a tooth for a crown, we prepare all 5 surfaces, as you see in the lower picture. There's a picture of a number 8 has been prepared in the top part, and in the lower part of the picture, number 8 has its crown in place. In this diagnosis tab, we see a charting with a black zigzag on each of the maxillary teeth. The legend on our left tells us that this is the symbol for a missing tooth. On the treatment planning tab, we would use the symbol for maxillary denture for each of the teeth. On the lower, we see other symbols and colors: red, blue, purple, orange, green. The green zigzag on number 30 indicates a minor fracture. Below the odontogram, we see the written description that corresponds to each of the symbols. Another thing to note would be the facial of number 31. The red on number 31 is on the root surface. So this indicates that number 31 has caries in the cervical third of the root on the facial.
In this picture, our dentiform patient on number 19,
the first molar. Number 19 has an occlusal amalgam and a buccal pit amalgam. So on the odontogram, we would have blue for an existing amalgam on both the buccal and the occlusal portions of that odontogram. For operative, we use the appropriate color and then click on the portion of the circle to indicate which surface or surfaces are restored or have caries. Here we see the colors in salute that are used to represent operative procedures. Operative being the drilling and filling portion of dentistry. The blue, gray, and purple represent amalgams. Yellow, brown, and green represent composite. The difference between the colors would be whether it's existing, whether it's planned, or whether it is defective. So the blue and purple are going to be seen on the diagnosis tab, and the gray would be seen in the treatment planning tab.